All right, the audience is filing in. Michael, why don't we turn down the music? I have a nice little fade out. And let me welcome everyone to this special 2022 Volunteer Appreciation and Recognition event. I'm thrilled to be able to come and join you as a co-host for this session. I'm Steve Fechtel from Talent Development and Learning. I'm with some of my colleagues, Alyssa and Michael, from my team and from our Mount Sinai Spotlight Committee, who helps do recognition and appreciation events around the system and programming. I know a lot of our members are involved in this event as well. But I'm going to bring up some special guests who are really the hosts of this event are Dana Kufner and Sherry Kaplan, who I'm going to introduce in just a moment. It's their team that really organized and put together this special event with the volunteer department leaders around the system. So we're thrilled for this to be the first time as a system all the volunteer programs came together to celebrate as part of Volunteer Appreciation Week. And we're here to thank you. It's our time to honor you. We're going to do a little history. We're going to have some words from our leadership come in here, talk about the past year, all of your success stories, and most importantly, how you were all back this past year after some time away during the pandemic. And really going to cover and thank you for your commitment to patient care, the compassion you've shared with patients and families and with our colleagues here at Mount Sinai, and your dedication to furthering basic and clinical research, and of course your staff for the entire Mount Sinai community. So thank you for that. I'm gonna introduce Director of Volunteer Services, my co-host here for this event, Director of Volunteer Services for Mount Sinai Hospital and Icahn School of Medicine, Sherry Kaplan. Hello, Sherry.
Hi, Steve. Thank you so much. We are absolutely thrilled to be here. It looks like we've made it. We're finally back together as a volunteer family. We've got people in our office and we are thrilled. Today's celebration coincides, as you said, with Healthcare Volunteer Week 2022, which is April 17th to 23rd this year. For Mount Sinai Hospital, this year marks the 70th anniversary of the Department of Volunteer Services, which is a platinum anniversary. It's also the first time we have celebrated together as a health system. I am honored and thrilled to share today's festivities with our colleagues at 8 hospital sites. We've worked as a team, the Mount Sinai value of teamwork, to bring together all of our talented and caring volunteers and volunteer department leaders to create today's celebration. So Steve, who have we got in the house?
Yeah, you said you got a group out there. Is there like a little watch party going on at Mount Sinai Hospital?
We got a watch party.
We've got to get our Jumbotron going. Let's see. All right. Hello. There's the Mount Sinai Hospital watch party. Oh, you got to spin your 7 around. Let's see that big 70 out there. Thank you. What is that, popcorn? You guys have popcorn at your party. Who am I seeing? South Nassau has a great party over there. Feel free to pop off mute if you can and give us a big cheer, but you might not be able to reach it where you are. And then I see Mount Sinai Queens. Let's see those. Oh, you got, yeah, pop off. That's excellent. Well, whether you're at a big party like this to watch or you're alone. Oh, there we go. All right. Or you're alone in your home or an office coming to join us, we really thank you for being here today. We're going to go around to all 8 hospitals for a little short presentation. But before we go around and start to meet everyone out there, this is about you. Participate in the chat. If you're a volunteer out there, you have your own thought, a word that describes your experience, a sentence or a phrase you want to share with all the volunteers, that chat is open for all. Please let your thoughts be heard and share what brings you joy as a volunteer and what you appreciate about volunteering here at Mount Sinai. And of course, if you're here to celebrate our volunteers, put that cheers into the chat. We're going to do some spotlighting like this. Sherry and I are in the spotlight. But you control your view. So anytime if you want to go back and see everybody, just find your view button in the upper right-hand corner and you can switch back to gallery. And we'll highlight some speakers as we go. And the first speakers we want to highlight are a couple of our senior leaders from Mount Sinai Hospital in Queens and from the Icahn School of Medicine to welcome you and express their appreciation. I'm going to be joined by Dr. David Rich, President and Chief Operating Officer of Mount Sinai Hospital and President of Mount Sinai Queens, and Dr. Dennis Charney, the Ann and Joel Ehrenkranz Dean of the Icahn School of Medicine at Mount Sinai and President for Academic Affairs for the Mount Sinai Health System. Let's start with Dr. Rich, if we can bring you up into the spotlight and hear from you to welcome and thank our volunteers.
Well, thank you, Steve. And this has been a long-standing tradition at Mount Sinai Hospital. And the greatest news that I've heard so far today is that we're doing it as an entire system. There is nothing that speaks more to that spirit of Mount Sinai than coming together, all eight hospitals, and just learning from one another, learning just how to support each other. And there's nothing that brings more joy to my heart than this annual event celebrating our volunteers, because who else among us, other than our volunteers, are here solely based upon your own goodwill, your own commitment to our mission? It's really inspiring and just so wonderful. I do want to mention a couple of things, because the pandemic created such disruption in all of our lives, and our volunteers responded in such an important way, delivering meal trays, creating the in the At the Ready program, scanning documents, assembling care packages, virtually tutoring some of our employees' kids, answering phones, managing vaccine pod lines. I saw so many of you in the worst days of those very crowded vaccine lines, just making people feel good and, you know, decreasing their anxiety, the waits, the crowding, the uncertainty. Our volunteers were there for everyone. All of this happened in addition to the existing programs. No one ever stopped the work with Adolescent Health Center tutoring, the Ambassador Program, MyChart, bedside tablet activation in the hospitals, providing that special program in the emergency department that we call the CARE program, our amazing Child Life Department, the Hospital Delirium Program, where people sit with our patients and help them stay calmer and focused and reorient them in a very disorienting environment. And of course, our help with Mount Sinai Health Partners. This has been really a remarkable example over these past 2 years, how our volunteers have gone above and beyond. And I'm honored and privileged to be one of the people to greet you and to welcome you to this celebration. I believe it is now my duty to hand off to our Dean, Dennis Charney, to say some other words to welcome everyone. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, thank you, David. And you know, thank you to Steve and Sherry. Your enthusiasm is very inspiring. Just shut this off. You know, adversity reveals character. And what you, our volunteers, have done over the last couple of years in helping us get through the pandemic has revealed what kind of individuals you are. And we thank you at the bottom of our heart. The volunteers have contributed in countless ways, not only in the last 2 years, but since the medical school's inception, and particularly over the last 2 years. I'm so grateful. 2021, you know, brought us Omicron, new challenges, ever-changing constraints, but you, our volunteers, never stopped working alongside our researchers to help us get to what we needed to do to provide outstanding care and make discoveries that change the lives of our patients. You also, helped our medical students and our graduate students fill gaps, and you offered whatever support was needed at all times. And when employees became sick with COVID-19 and our resources were even tighter, you stepped up again. For example, in the past year alone, 182 research volunteers supported groundbreaking work in 64 of our departments and institutes. We couldn't do without you. Additionally, the Department of Volunteer Services onboarded 415 students from institutions around the country. These students came to Mount Sinai to gain clinical experience that is central to what they are going to become in terms of being doctors and scientists. In 2021, the DVS became the door for many of our DEI students. These pipeline programs offer talented youth both exposure and preparations for careers in science and healthcare. They are an integral part, as you are, of our institution's anti-racism roadmap. After 70 years, this department has grown and evolved to meet the institutional needs. But one thing has not changed. I want to repeat that. One thing has not changed. The strength and compassion of Mount Sinai volunteers who share their hearts and their dedication. Thank you very much.
Wonderful. All right. Thank you both to Dr. Rich and Dr. Charney for your opening comments and words to welcome and celebrate our volunteers. I'm inspired by hearing the list and list of ways volunteers have helped throughout these past few years. And as Dr. Charney said, for 70 years and even before then, before there was a department, volunteerism was always a part of caring for our patients. You know, Sherry, I'm going to get a video set up. We have another leader who wanted to express by video some words. Let me get that ready. Why don't you do an introduction for us?
Absolutely. Thank you to our leadership. I'm so, so proud to be in the company of volunteers from all across our system and to celebrate the rich, creative, and diverse volunteer services that each of you brings to Mount Sinai. As we honor you today, we know that each of you is uniquely compassionate and makes a magnificent contribution. Volunteers can be found in every corner of this great institution, from bedside to building entrances, and from the stat room to the emergency room. But if there's one thing you all have in common, it's the central role you play in enriching patient and family experiences. So to help us in honoring all of you, it's my great pleasure to introduce Erica Rubenstein, Vice President of Service Excellence and Patient Experience for the Mount Sinai Health System, and the Joseph F. Kullman. I know the Kullman Institute and the Joseph F. Kullman Jr. Institute for Patient Experience, and to the Kullman family for their generous support of patient experience programming. And they're on our call today. Right. Susan and Edgar.
Erica.
Well.
Hello, everyone. I'm thrilled to be here and to see the first Mount Sinai Health System-wide virtual volunteer recognition event. Today's event reflects the coming together of eight wonderful volunteer programs across our health system. Congratulations to the amazing volunteers who brighten our patients' experiences just by being there. Volunteers, you put your hearts into everything you do. You bring love, compassion, and generosity into every experience here in our hospitals. We are so thrilled that we can welcome you back to our hospitals after this long, long period of time where we've had to have so few of you coming in. Our patients and staff have missed our ambassador volunteers at our hospital entrances, wayfinding and comforting our patients, as well as our patient care volunteers at bedside and in our EDs. I also want to extend a special thank you on behalf of the Joseph F. Kullman Jr. Institute for Patient Experience for all that you do to comfort, care, and support our patients and families. And a huge thank you to Susan and Edgar Kullman for their generosity and leadership in making all of our work possible. Thank you so much.
All right, thanks to Erica. And we put the Kullmans in our spotlight so we can get a wave from Edgar Kullman and Susan Kullman. Thank you so much for joining us and celebrating our volunteers today. All right, with that, we're gonna keep this show moving. Now, Sherry, I believe if I consulted my script here, next up, we're gonna stay right here with Mount Sinai Hospital, with your group that's celebrating next door in their watch party, and talk about this 70-year history for a little bit at Mount Sinai Hospital. Anything to share before we get some photos up? I think we had some interesting pictures to share that go back through the ages.
Absolutely, Steve. So as we celebrate the 70th anniversary of the Mount Sinai Volunteer Department, we've taken a look back and forward. We've done a lot of work these past few weeks, seeing what has evolved and all that is the pure volunteer goodness, that special sauce that we hope will never, ever change. To get us in the mood, though, we thought we should take a look back in time. And I was going to ask you, Steve, could you please pull up photo number one?
Yeah, Michael, I'm going to go to you. He's going to get these slides up for us. Some great pictures. Let's go to show view here for a second. Let's go full screen. Here we go. All right. So I got to take a guess here of what, and feel free to guess in the chat if you think you know what this group is. They're pretty young looking. Are these student volunteers?
Well, yes, Steve, these are high school student volunteers. This photo is actually from 1969, and you are looking at some high school volunteers who are visiting with the then director of volunteer services. If you see her on the bench, her name, yes, that is Mrs. Goldie Bromberg. Mrs. Goldie Bromberg, who officially became the director of volunteer services when Mount Sinai opened its official volunteer department in 1952.
Wow.
So she's sitting.
And how many directors have there been since Goldie?
So according to our research, Steve, some of you may recall Cynthia Levy, who is my predecessor, who was actually the longest serving director of volunteer services from 1979 to 2018. Wow. Dana and I spoke with Cynthia yesterday, and she sends her very, very warm regards. She was director of volunteer services for, can anyone guess? Do the math, it's 39 years, which is pretty astounding. Cynthia sends her warm regards, shared a lot of great memories. And we also did some math. We realized that Goldie was director for at least 17 years from 1969-ish to when Cynthia, 52 to 79. And I don't think I'm going to last quite that long, Steve. I don't know if I've got 39 years in me, but I'm going to do the best I can.
Go for the 17.
So, I'll go for the 17.
That sounds there you good. Go. Oh, that's excellent. So the whole history, just a few directors. You're only 2 degrees of separation from this image.
There was one other person. We don't know who she was, but I think you've got the three main ones. Well, yes.
There we go. So make sure you get some shots like this. You never know when it's going to come back and be in an never event know. Like this 70 years from now. Michael, let's go to the next picture. So this, what am I seeing here? This looks like maybe even before 69.
So this is actually circa 1968. This is a Mount Sinai photo depicting the Mount Sinai volunteer tee. And we were very impressed with this photograph. I believe it might have been the first volunteer tee. And then we started looking into, well, what other ways have volunteers been celebrated over the years? So we found out that there was originally a sherry tasting party. There were cocktail parties. Cynthia told us that one year they had not adequate space, so she hired an omelet chef for the hallways for all the volunteers to have fresh omelets. And then, of course, we know the Nova and cream cheese and the mini bagels. I think Dr. Rich really loves those. I know I do. And then most recently, we've added yogurt parfaits. So who knows what's for next year, but I hope we'll be celebrating in person.
And, well, exactly. I know everyone would love to be in person for an event that's so emotional like this to see each other. And we'll be there. First step, our volunteers are back. And that's the big celebration, you know, after time away. And next step is getting back in person. But imagine what this group would think of if they saw us celebrating in this way. How futuristic is this to that group to be all together virtually across 8 hospitals? All right, Michael, let's go. We got one more.
Okay, so we're fast forwarding. We're fast forwarding to 1973. These volunteers were all children of Mount Sinai staff. And as you can see, you might wonder why they're not wearing blue jackets, because that was a later iteration, but they're wearing candy striper dresses. And there's one young man. They are doing STEM before it was actually called STEM. You see them in a laboratory. And our uniforms have certainly changed a lot since that time. Cynthia told us about finding a big garbage bag filled with pink and white pinafores that she was got rid of and then started with the volunteer department jacket. And I think we're due for a refresh shortly. So if anyone has ideas, yeah, we would love to take your ideas.
Well, I want to ask, how many of you volunteered at an era where you would have been a candy striper and worn this uniform? Sherry, you?
I had one.
Where's that picture?
I don't got it. It's not here. Not here.
Anyone else out there, let us know in the chat if you were ever one, or maybe a family member was, you remember this very vividly. I see Phyllis already in the chat recognized the room from the last photo as the Rumpus Room at 5 East 98th Street. So we've got people who've been in Mount Sinai for a long time and can recognize these locations. All right. Well, if any other candy stripers out there or remembered someone who was maybe in their family, give us a shout out. There we go. Rebecca was. All right. There you go. Well, thank you, Sherry. This was great. Michael, we can pull these photos down. I know you have a video. You said, well, let's look at the past, but now it's maybe present and future. I can get that queued up for you if you want to do an introduction.
Absolutely. Thank you. So whether then or now, volunteers at all stages of their lives choose to give their time, energy, and expertise to Mount Sinai. From those just beginning their journey into the work world to the world of retirees. In 2021, MSH volunteers ranged in age from 15 to 80-something. Volunteer service can be generational, passing as a tradition from one generation to the next. We actually know of Mount Sinai volunteers who are at least second and possibly third generation Mount Sinai volunteers. Some of you are actually on this call. I see you. And this past year saw the retirement of many longstanding Mount Sinai employees. So what did they do upon retirement? They wanted to return to their Mount Sinai family, this time wearing new blue volunteer jackets. Many others of you, I will call septuagenarians plus, anyone who's 70 years of age or perhaps a bit more. Many of you have been volunteering your entire lives. So I asked several of you to come in and to join me and reflect upon the meaning of volunteerism to you, especially at their ripe, forever young ages. And here's what they had to say.
A different and wonderful stage of life in some ways, you know, for that someone or an institution has existed for 70 years and is still thriving, as Mount Sinai.
70 is a wonderful number. It means a milestone. 70 means freedom to me.
70, when I was 70, I felt I was still very young.
70 means that this department's been doing great things for a long, long time.
It's not as old as I thought it was.
70, well, if I think about me, 70, I can't remember when I was 70 or what I was doing, but I probably was volunteering.
I was surprised because I said, wait a minute, am I supposed to feel different now that I'm 70?
I worked 3 years in the emergency department. And when I left at night, I would say to myself, I did something important today.
There are many things that I've done, but most of all, I have derived tremendous satisfaction from enriching my life.
When I have successes, which is not all of the time, but most of the time, I feel very fulfilled.
I got a lot of pleasure giving out books.
The opportunity to volunteer at the hospital is an opportunity for me to give back something to a place that I enjoy.
It's gratifying to give back, to feel productive, to feel useful, to feel that I'm helping people get through their day.
Volunteering has meant an opportunity to, I will say, help people, solve problems, and you know, associate and meet new people, fellow volunteers, who are, you know, we can share that. It's like a lot of camaraderie.
It's incredible because I volunteered here many, many years ago after my husband had died, and it saved me. I had a place to go when I woke up in the morning, and it changed my life. It changed my life.
And I have to be honest that the acoustics here are wonderful. It's like playing in a concert hall. And I feel that maybe in some tiny little way that I can reach out and help people who are going through a hard time.
And the fact that my visit cheered him so much, that I made that much of a difference in his life, touched me deeply.
Mother called me in an absolute fit of excitement to tell me that her daughter had been accepted to the Bronx High School of Science. And that for me was the moment. That's why I do it.
It was a lot of satisfaction.
Well, I've always felt that Mount Sinai is in my DNA.
I used the one word that I, you know, I knew in Korean, which I said, "Gamsahamnida," and that lit him up, you know, just saying.
I was giving out the juice and cookies and little toys, and this little boy came up to me and said, "You have the best job."
And I just looked at him, and then he threw his arms around me and hugged me and thanked me. And so it gave me an opportunity to thank him for being so big and brave and getting his vaccine. And I floated the rest of the day.
Full.
Volunteering makes me feel rich, and I will do it until I can no longer speak.
Delighted to be part of Mount Sinai, just, and all the you wonderful people in the volunteer department. I feel that this is, I've made friends here, and it's been very, very endearing and comforting to me.
If you have an opportunity and you're capable of doing things, you should volunteer. You'll get the benefit. Forget about helping others. You will benefit from doing something.
Makes me feel productive, I think would be the best word. One word.
It brings me great gratitude to be able to help other women in the early stages of fighting this disease.
Not one word. Doing the right thing. It's an example of doing the right thing.
Grateful for what I have and what I do.
Well, right now it makes me feel like I can make a contribution to people.
I'm 81 years young.
According to my birth certificate, I'm 74 years old. But I feel ageless.
I am 73 years young.
I'll be 84 in May.
I'm 91.
I turned 83 in November last year.
I am 76 years young. I don't know how young, but old.
So I would say I'm 81 and a half years old.
I'm 72 this year. And it's not as bad as I thought it would be.
Wonderful. Thank you to all our volunteers who participated in that video. Eileen Solomon, you got me to cry again. I cried yesterday when I heard your line when I first previewed this video, and it got me again there. Very, very beautiful. And thank you to all for sharing your thoughts. Sherry, wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you.
I think it's time now with that, and thank you and congrats on 70 years at Mount Sinai Hospital. And from here, we're going to jump around the system. We've got 7 other hospitals to go to out there. So at this time, for the second half of this session, we're going to bounce around to all these wonderful leaders and volunteer groups around the system. Before we go there, I'm going to talk about one program and ask Silver Sergenian to come on up to talk about the SAVI program, Sexual Assault and Violence Intervention Program, because it spans across many of our hospitals. So welcome, Silva.
Thanks, Steve. Thank you so much to all of the Mount Sinai volunteers for your service. As the coordinator for the Mount Sinai SAVI program, I am fortunate to work with our amazing volunteer emergency department advocates who help survivors of sexual assault and intimate partner violence. These advocates come to the ED to be with our patients that have gone through traumatic assaults to make sure that they are supported, understand what to expect, know what their rights are, and to make sure that that patient's voice is heard. In 2021, our volunteers gave 11,000 hours of service and assisted 525 patients across Mount Sinai Hospital, Mount Sinai Queens, Mount Sinai Brooklyn, and several other hospitals throughout the city, providing invaluable support to our patients who needed it. Our advocates have been flexible and done amazing work, both remotely and in person during the worst of the pandemic. And then they were eager to go back into the emergency department as soon as the COVID vaccine was available. We also have volunteer troubleshooters, and these are our experienced advocates who commit to being on call for 1 week at a time, nights and weekends. And they not only support our volunteer advocates by answering questions and helping navigate complicated situations, but they also support our survivors when no volunteer advocate is available. And they have been in high demand this year. So we are so grateful for all of our SAVI volunteers and the time and generosity that they have given to our patients.
Welcome. Thank you so much, Silva. That's wonderful. If you're a volunteer in this area, please shout yourself out in the chat, say hello, and thank you for that. You know, with that, I'm going to go to Mount Sinai Beth Israel next, because I know they have some folks they heard from who are in victim services advocate programs. They also have their pet therapy, BI Cares, high school internships. So to hear more about this, I'm going to go to Dina Jacobson. There you are, Dina. Welcome.
Hello, everybody. Thank you. I would like to thank all of the volunteers for your incredible support of the patients and staff. In a few minutes, we will watch videos about Fia Shaw, a high school intern who's being mentored by Marie Morse and Jordan Enney in the Infection Prevention Department of Mount Sinai Beth Israel, as well as videos of Minyoung Letty and Tess Duncan, who are victim services advocates. Both of these programs continued virtually during the pandemic and have now returned on site. Before we watch these videos, I would like to ask Dr. Barnett, the Chief Medical Officer of Mount Sinai Beth Israel and Mount Sinai Downtown, to say a few words. Dr. Barnett.
Thank you, Dina. I want to thank you first and foremost for all that you do for us. And we are truly blessed to have such dedicated and compassionate volunteers. And we're very grateful. Our patients are grateful. Our staff are grateful. Families are grateful. Thank you to all our incredible volunteers for everything you do for us every day. Greatly appreciated.
All right. Thank you. And with that, Dina, I'll play your video.
Thank you.
My experience has been pretty fulfilling. I've been able to learn about electronic medical records training. I've been able to learn more about Paul Farmer and his work with the Partners in Health. I've been able to do ethics in medical research training, as well as learning about the racial and socioeconomic disparities in hospitalized patients with COVID-19. In the future, I will be more aware about the social determinants of health and the impact in society.
It's been an honor and a humbling experience to be a volunteer advocate for victim services at Mount Sinai Beth Israel. My journey as a volunteer advocate has been rewarding, knowing that I was able to walk alongside the survivors when they came into the emergency department. There were times that I felt disappointed when I had thought that I wasn't able to help them. But what I learned was the survivors were always appreciative, knowing that you were there for them.
Hi, my name is Tess, and I'm a victim services advocate at Mount Sinai Beth Israel. That means that I act as the primary support to survivors of sexual assault and intimate partner violence during their time in the emergency room. I started volunteering in April 2021, so just about a year now. My experience with the victim services program has been so incredibly rewarding. It's been challenging, but I've been so well supported by our program coordinators and the training that they've given to us that was just so thorough and thoughtfully constructed. I've also been really grateful to connect with some amazing people who were part of my training cohort, who just taught me so much as well. I've learned a lot from this experience, but the main thing that comes to mind for me is how to hold space for people when they need it. When I first started, it was tough to resist the urge to fill silences between myself and the survivor, but those silences were really essential to a key tenet of the victim services program, which is to hold space. It was really vital to give survivors the chance to process and share anything they might want to, and just never let my own anxieties interfere with that. So it became really clear to me that it was okay and sometimes necessary to say less. And I've already benefited from this experience so much. It's helped me become a better listener and a better support to people in my life when they're in need. I've been able to apply these skills that I've gained from the program in both my personal and professional life, and I'm just so grateful to everyone involved in the program for giving me this opportunity.
All right, well, thank you so much, Dina, for highlighting these programs and to all of your volunteers at Mount Sinai Beth Israel. Shout out to all of you from Beth Israel. Let us know you're out there. And thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, with that, we're going to keep moving and go out to Mount Sinai, Brooklyn. I know we are going to have Emily come join us. Emily, let me get your presentation up and ready, but if you want to do your welcome.
Yeah, thank you so much, Steve. So on behalf of Mount Sinai Brooklyn Hospital, I want to extend a huge thank you to our super dedicated volunteers who have been with us. They're so valuable to us. And we're so excited to welcome them back after 2 years of the pandemic as well. And I know Roman is really sad to miss this event, but he did help us to spotlight a few of our volunteers who are sharing their excitement about returning as volunteers at Mount Sinai Brooklyn as well.
Right, let's go to some of them. I've got some videos queued up here, but first tell us about each.
Sure. So Mike was calling the hospital every other week during the height of the pandemic, eager to get back and help the patients with all their non-clinical needs. He was the first returning volunteer. Mike is rushing to MSB every other day as soon as his college classes are over. Here's what he wanted to share with us.
Coming back to volunteer at Mount Sinai Brooklyn is a great experience because you can do so many things here that you can't do as an intern at a clinic or other medical sites. You're able to help the nurses, the staff, and the patients here with basic tasks. You get such a hands-on experience in a medical field, which gives you such knowledge towards medical school, whatever medical career you're going into in the future.
Right, and next up.
Okay, so Shlomo was very excited to hear that he can come back to Mount Sinai, Brooklyn. He enjoys cheering up patients and thinks that the warm encouragement and compassion he's sharing with each and every patient he visits is the foundation of their positive health outcomes.
In these times, the volunteer program was closed, and I used to come in before the pandemic. I was there every single week, rotating between school and the volunteer program at Mount Sinai. And it was a very important part to me to be able to give back to the community, to be able to interact with patients, interact with the visitors, to be there in the emergency department when needed. It is just very important for us to be there, and for it to finally be open, it's amazing. It really is.
All right, and last.
Okay. All right, so Frankie is a fixture at Mount Sinai Brooklyn lobby area for years. He is loved by all visitors and feels like he's part of the security office team. He wanted everyone to hear that he is ready to return to his greening duties very soon.
Well, I am real happy to be coming back here. The break that we have with the COVID, I'm so happy to be doing something at Mount Sinai because I feel like it's my second family and everything. I love all the people, and I love helping all the anybody I could. If they don't know how to get where they have to go, I love helping them out. Thank you to Mount Sinai for everything that they did for me, too. Thank you very much.
All right, and thank you, Emily. Wonderful to hear from them.
Thank you so much, Steve. Yeah, so the best is yet to come, and we're so excited to have our volunteers back.
Okay, thanks. Round of applause for our Mount Sinai Brooklyn volunteers. Thank you for sharing, Emily Shore. From there, we're going to go out to Mount Sinai, Queens. Now, for time, I want to make sure we have time for all of our groups. We might skip this intro, but you let us know. Mount Sinai, Queens, you know, in the Astoria community, it's been a part of Mount Sinai since 1999. Do you know what the original name was? It's had four other names. What was the original name? If you know it, shout it out. I'll give it away the answer after we hear from Anna Rodriguez. Welcome, Anna. You have a watch party going on out there too, don't you? Let's go see that party with Anna.
Yes, we do. Thank you, Steve, and thank you, everyone. And you're correct. Mount Sinai Queens has gone through various iterations over the last 125 years history of serving our wonderful community. And volunteerism itself has adapted to meet the needs of the current times. However, you know, what has remained constant is the desire of our volunteers to support our hospital's mission, to enhance the patient experience, and to support our team and community. Volunteers are truly love in motion. Please welcome Dr. Matthew Bai, Associate Director, Emergency Department, and volunteer Ahmed Abdu, as they share their experience.
Hi, my name is Matthew Bai. I'm the Associate Medical Director at the Mount Sinai Queens Emergency Department.
Hi, my name is Ahmed Abdu, and I'm a volunteer at Mount Sinai Queens.
So I want to take this opportunity to really appreciate our volunteers. They make a huge impact in our patient experience. The hospital is typically not the most familiar or inviting place, but our volunteers, like yourself, make a huge difference to make people's day better and their experience here better. The emergency department, especially when people come, it's probably not their best day. and you improve their environment, you improve their feelings when they're here. The pandemic really shed some light on exactly how much difference you guys make. We really missed you while you were gone during the pandemic, and we're so happy to have you guys back. Happy Volunteer Appreciation Week.
Thank you so much, Dr. Bai. It's definitely a pleasure to be here and make an impact on our community.
All right, thanks so much. And let's hear it for that party that's going on over there too. Let's see some action over there, these three volunteers joining you.
Thank you so much, Steve. And on behalf of the entire team at Mount Sinai Queens, we thank our wonderful volunteers, especially those who are here with us. And you know, they're simply the best. Thank you so much.
All right, thank you. And I think Judy's got it, right? Is that our correct answer? Astoria General. She said, well, it was Astoria General in 49. It was Western Queens in 93. It was Daly's Astoria Sanatorium in 1925. But the original was Astoria Hospital. Well, yeah. Back before, but good for you, Judy, knowing it was Astoria General at one point. All right. Thank you, Anna. Thank you so much, everyone at Mount Sinai Queens. Moving on, next, we're going to go out to, looks like Mount Sinai West is up next. Let me go to Maribel Fiol, who's going to talk about our group at Mount Sinai West.
Hi, good afternoon. So I just want to give a big thank you to our volunteers. You know, for we're so grateful for their time and dedication to our hospital and to our patients. So we're excited to restart and rebuilding our volunteer programs like pet therapy, patient rounding, our Take 10 T-Cart. So again, a big thank you to our volunteers. They've been great. So now I'll hand it over to Kenneth Gersuch. He's been a longtime lobby ambassador volunteer here at Mount Sinai West.
All right,
thank you, Maribel. My name is Ken. I retired in 2008. From a tightly knit church community, for which I was a pastor. And then I was looking for volunteer opportunities and found them at what is now Mount Sinai West, which has become a very special place in the world and a community for me. For a dozen years since then, I've come here 2 days a week. My wife, Judith, also is a volunteer here in ambulatory surgery. My activities have been quite varied, but not long ago, the staff put on a bright coat, understated in this video, and provided us the fancy title of ambassador and sent us to swim in the usually gentle commotion of the main lobby. We massage six or seven different lines which intertwine and mingle. We welcome people in and send them out with greeting. We try to bring elements of peace and respect and patience, and as often as I can, laughter to the stresses of everyone who's in there. There's a large revolving door. It's like a rotary heart. It pumps people in and out of the lobby. And in that lobby is the most varied array of people I think I have discovered anywhere in the world, of all stations and conditions and ages and languages. It's just amazing. And we're all there, all of us, with the elemental need to receive and to give competent, compassionate care. I've learned that every single staff member has a vital role in healing. I am rewarded every day with the appreciation people have for the simple things that we do as part of it all. And I'm rewarded with the friendship of many among the professional staff. It's a healing community for me as well. And I'm really grateful. So thanks to you all, and bless you for what you do, every one of you.
Thank you so much, Ken. We all thank you. Thank your wife as well for both volunteering at Mount Sinai West. And I have another video I'm going to bring up of some of the leadership at Mount Sinai West, who also wanted to express thanks to you and to all the volunteers here today.
One of the very difficult things during the pandemic was that we couldn't allow our volunteers into the hospital. Now that they're back, we are so excited. They do so many wonderful things for us and our patients.
So we've already seen the difference in our emergency department and our ambulatory surgery areas and our lobby. Our staff are so happy to have them back. They're a key part of our team, and we wish them all a wonderful week as we celebrate you.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks so much to our volunteers at Mount Sinai West. A big round of applause for them. Thank you again, Ken, for sharing your personal insights into volunteerism that is a part of your life. Thank you. We're going to move on to our next group. Let me bring them up. We've got just a few to go. I'm going to go right into the video for this one. At Mount Sinai Morningside, Amy Bush, who leads the program there, could not join us, but she had another event, and she collected some of the leaders to share their thoughts of appreciation for our volunteers. So we'll go right to it.
Hi, I'm Amy Bush, Director of Volunteer Services. And for Healthcare Volunteer Week, what a better way to celebrate than to come together as a group and focus on the remarkable contributions of our volunteers. I am so sorry I could not be there in person, but I'm excited to take a moment to honor the Mount Sinai Morningside volunteers for their amazing contributions and their long history at the hospital. Volunteer services at Morningside goes back to as early as 1914. And while the programs have changed, our mission remains the same, to provide the hospital with highly competent, qualified volunteers who consistently provide excellent service to enhance the patient experience. In March of 2020, volunteer programs were suspended due to COVID. When it was safe to return, our dedicated volunteers resumed their service in the emergency department, focusing on patient rounding with an eye towards comfort. I am so proud of this extraordinary group of volunteers who were ready to pull on their masks and eye protection and get back to work in the ED. You are truly remarkable. Actually, all of our volunteers are remarkable. We are currently a strong team of 65 volunteers providing service throughout the hospital, including inpatient units, administrative departments, delirium program, and ambulatory surgery. Volunteers at Morningside and throughout the health system are essential to patient care, and I am not the only one who thinks so.
Good afternoon, all. My name is Carol DeJesus. I am the Vice President for Care Transitions and Population Health here at Mount Sinai Morningside. I welcome you all to this celebration of our volunteers. I specifically want to thank and recognize all our volunteers for their hard work and dedication to the patients of Mount Sinai. Here at Mount Sinai Morningside, you're an integral part of our daily lives. You mean so much to our patients and to our staff. You're embedded within us and part of our team. And that is so important to us. So I just really want to take that time to thank you and recognize you. So thanks.
From all of us in the emergency department at Mount Sinai Morningside, thank you for your service. We are so grateful for the essential role you play in our emergency department. Our patients and staff truly appreciate you and the work you do. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Kathleen Frisiam-Dory, Director for Nursing Education at Mount Sinai Morningside. And on behalf of all of nursing at Morningside, I want to thank you for helping to keep our units and departments running smoothly, for going above and beyond for our patients, and for the kindness that you bring each and every time you serve. And on a personal note, I've had volunteers in nursing education multiple times, and we love them. Thank you again. We appreciate you.
So to wrap up, I want to leave you with a quote by Helen Keller. She said, "I long to accomplish a great and noble task, but it is my chief duty to accomplish humble tasks as though they were great and noble. The world is moved along not only by the mighty shoves of its heroes, but also by the aggregate of the tiny pushes of each honest worker. each of you, every time you show up to the hospital and you refill a water pitcher or find a wheelchair for a patient or spend time talking with a patient who's afraid, you are accomplishing humble tasks that are great and noble. That honest work creates a better experience for our patients and our community. We are better because of you. Thank you.
All right, and thank you. Shout out to all of our volunteers out at Mount Sinai Morningside. And thank you, Amy, for putting together that video. We've got two groups to go. We want to save time for them, so I'm going to go straight out to New York. Eye and Ear is next. Without further ado, you know, New York Eye and Ear is America's first specialty hospital. They had their 200th anniversary in 2020. I don't know if volunteerism goes back 200 years, but Christine, let's hear more about your volunteers at New York Eye and Ear.
Thank you, Steve, and a huge thank you to all of our volunteers for your commitment and service to our hospital staff, patients, and visitors, and for always going above and beyond to provide the best patient experience. Today, I'd like to recognize a former volunteer who is now a colleague, Rohin Dhanraj. Rohin began volunteering at New York Eye and Ear in high school and continued with us while she attended college. In her 7 years of volunteering, she completed over 1,500 hours of service up until the time she formally started her career at the infirmary. Rohin is with us here today, and I'd like to invite her to say a few words and share her experience with us.
Hi, everyone. Good afternoon. I would like first to start off by thanking the volunteer department. The volunteer department had allowed me to volunteer in multiple departments, such as admitting, the OR, second and fourth floor, and even the recovery floors, fifth, seventh, and ninth, just to name a few. After volunteering in the various departments, I was able to obtain valuable knowledge and skills that I have been utilizing throughout my career. After enjoying volunteering at New York Eye and Ear, I applied for an open position as a registrar in the admitting department. After a few years, I worked my way up as a team lead, and then I had the opportunity to expand my career in a new position as a patient care representative. After a few years of being a patient care representative, I continue to advance, and now I'm in my current position as a supervisor in the ENT department. And this is all thanks to the volunteer department for allowing me to volunteer in so many different departments and allowing me to obtain the knowledge that I currently have.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much, Rohin. I got to ask in the chat for everyone, anyone else who started their careers at Mount Sinai through volunteerism and through the volunteer department, let us know. And others that may have worked their careers at Mount Sinai and then moved on to volunteerism after retirement. I'd love to hear that too. Shout yourself out in the chat. And thank you, Christine.
Thank you. Congratulations to everyone and to Mount Sinai Hospital on your 70-year milestone.
Okay, thank you, New York Eye and Ear. We have one group to go. I know that watch party is out there ready. Let's go out to South Nassau. Let's see that group that's there celebrating together. And I'm going to welcome Anne-Marie Fernandez to talk with us. There's the cheering. All right, Anne-Marie, let's bring you up and hear about Mount Sinai South Nassau volunteers. Do we have Anne-Marie on a separate feed, or is she with the group? Because you're muted out there. Okay, they're going to go over to the screen. I believe they've got two special guests to share with some incredible service reputations out there at Mount Sinai South Nassau. So they're going to put themselves off mute. There you go.
Oh, fantastic. Thank you so much. We're so excited to be here with all of you today, celebrating Volunteers Week here in Oceanside, Long Island. I'm here with some of my volunteers who are so excited to be here today. We have some junior volunteers with us in the house. Two very special volunteers celebrating some milestones with you today. So I have my Susan Keller, who has been here since 1998, serving 27,000 hours this year. So we're very excited.
Wow, all right.
I appreciate all Susan does as a compassionate companion on the units and showing stroke videos to our stroke patients. She is here four to five, sometimes 5 days a week, depending on her availability, and we really rely on her, and she's been a trooper throughout the whole entire pandemic. So thank you, Susan, for all that you do. And in 2020, we obviously couldn't do our luncheon during the volunteer week, but we wanted to celebrate our volunteer, Ruth Fortin, who has provided 55 years of service.
Wow.
Ruth has served as a messenger for our hospital, moving around, delivering supplies, assembling packets, whatever is needed. She is the most calm, cooperative volunteer out there. She's amazing. So we're so excited. I also want to thank all of my volunteers, my spiritual care volunteers, the volunteers working in the lobby, our volunteers who do the book cards, volunteers everywhere throughout the whole hospital here. They have been truly amazing, and we're so blessed to have them as part of our hospital team here. So thank you so much for including us today.
Wow, congratulations to you all. 27,000 hours, 55 years of service, both incredible milestones that I know our audience is just in awe of. So thank you to all of our volunteers at Mount Sinai South Nassau, and for everyone out there, whether it's 27,000 hours or 55 years, or it's one day of being a volunteer that you came in and gave of yourself to assist others in our community and in our hospitals. You're appreciated this year and this week and as part of volunteer appreciation. So that's all of our groups around. Let's bring up Sherry, if you wanna come and close us out. And thanks for some of you sharing. Roy, who's been volunteering after 28 years of service, that's excellent as a hospital employee and now volunteering. So Sherry, a wonderful opportunity to meet and hear from some of these volunteers, either live or in video. I'm touched. How do you want to close this out here today? Just
thank you from the bottom of my heart to you, Steve, to all of our amazing volunteers, our colleagues at all the other sites, Dana Kiefner, our associate director, without whom this would not be possible, our team, leadership, everyone who has come together from all over the country to celebrate with us today. We're family. We are going to be together in person next year, I sure hope. And here's to good things and good health in the coming year. Warm love, regards to everyone. Let's celebrate.
Right. So that's closing out our episode today or this special session. But if you're there together with groups, keep celebrating. Go out and say thank you to a volunteer. You're going to walk by one in the hall today as you're out in the hospital. Make sure you say thank you to your volunteers. All right, Michael, let's hit the music. Thank you so much, everyone. Enjoy Patient Experience Week next week. And thank you to our volunteers. Go watch parties. Keep that party going. We are family. Woo! It's Anna. All right, join the groove. Some of these parties look like you almost choreographed. Just let me stay for a moment. We're giving love.